Next, Stoke theorem. Stoke theorem states that let S be an oriented piecewise smooth surface that is bounded by a simple closed piecewise smooth boundary curve C with the positive orientation. Let F be a vector field whose components have continuous partial derivative on an open region in R cube, that is, will be containing S. Then you can write the Stoke theorem as integration of f dot dr equal to double integration of curl f dot ds. Next, divergence theorem. The statement of divergence theorem states that let A be a simple solid region and S be the boundary surface of B given with the positive outward orientation. Let F be a vector field whose component function have continuous partial derivative on an open region that contains E. Then double integration of F dot ds equal to triple integration of divergence of B F into dB. So proof of the theorem, that is nothing but we are going to take the surface integral Pi plus Qj plus Rk into N into ds. Then this side triple integral of dx plus dy plus dz into dv. So separately we are equating each other, right hand side and left hand side, that is pi into n ds equal to triple integration of dx into dv. Similarly for qj, qj into n into ds equal to triple integral of dy into dv. So double integral of rk into n ds will be equal to triple integral of dz into dy. So we will show the last, the others will be similar. So on the boundary surface S2, which is the graph of U2, you can finally state that n ds is nothing but du square by dx or du2 by dy. In this manner you can write, okay. Then Stoke theorem is nothing but let S be an oriented piecewise smooth surface that is bounded by a simple closed piecewise smooth boundary curve C with the positive orientation. Let F be a vector field whose component have continuous partial derivative on an open region in R cube that contains S. Then you can write the single integration of F dr equal to double integration of curl F into ds. Similarly, divergence theorem is nothing but E be a simple solid region, S be the boundary surface of E given with the positive orientation. Let F be a vector field whose component function have continuous partial derivative on an open region that contain E. Then double integration of F into ds will give triple integration of divergence of F into dv.